The five, who included Irina Nabisubi, the Telecom Relations Manager, Equity Bank, Crescent Tumsimi, the Equity Bank Relations Officer, Wycliffe Asimwe, the Marketing Manager, Julius Muchibi, Head of Agency Banking, and Fred Simogerere, a banker, were this morning arraigned before the Anti-Corruption Magistrate Court. Before Magistrate Albert Asimwe, the five were each charged with two counts of obtaining credit by false pretense, two counts of money laundering, and one count of conspiracy to defraud. They all pleaded innocent to the charges.
You, Nabisubi Irina, between the years 2021 to 2024 at Equity Bank, Church House in Kampala City, being employed as a relationship manager, Telecom, incurred a debt of Ghana shillings 300 million from Equity Bank, falsely representing that the loans were being applied for by Nagawa Ratifa.
Before remanding them, Albert Asimwe, the presiding magistrate, asked prosecution to speed up inquiries into the charges. And two accused persons informed them that this court cannot entertain any application from them, be it a bail application, and advised them to apply for bail in the High Court, which has the jurisdiction to hear such a grave offence. The matter was adjourned to 12th April 2024, and the suspects remanded to Luzira prisons till then.
It has delayed, this being the first day. I want to encourage you to speed up investigation.
Prosecution states that between 2021 and 2024, the accused persons, being employees of Equity Bank, obtained a loan of over 6.5 billion shillings falsely, presenting that the said loan is being applied for by another person. The accused persons went ahead and obtained another loan of 300 million shillings under the disguise of another bank client. On the charge of money laundering, the accused persons are said to have initiated the transfer of 6.5 billion shillings, which they had falsely obtained as a loan in the name of one Gladys Najemba. On the charge of conspiracy to defraud, the five accused persons are said to have conspired to defraud Equity Bank of 62 billion shillings by fraudulently causing the disbursement of the unsecured loans at unqualified persons. Story compiled by Rachel Nachiwala for the news.